A wee a mama way. So, in one of the last few videos I made, Ava and her boyfriend, or her fiance Douglas, were going to be waiting at Fort Laramie, but so was her father. I don't see them here, though, unless that's what Lewis Southworth is talking about. You going west too? James is taking me to Oregon, despite the laws saying black folk like me can't settle there. Too bad he sold my fiddle before we left. It was the best friend I ever had. I was hoping to raise some money by playing at forts to pay James for my freedom. I could play you a song that would set your foot to tapping, that's for sure. Or my name's not Lewis Southworth. Darn, I sure do miss that instrument. I asked James if I could keep it, but he needed the money for this trip, or so he said. The man kicks at the dirt despondently. We're gonna help. If you're offering to buy me a new fiddle, I won't say no, but money doesn't grow on trees, or I'd have picked myself a finer suit than this. He gives us a wide grin. Well, hold on now. If we're going to do this, you've got to do it right, you understand? I'm talking about putting a band together. I could even earn enough to pay you back for the cost of the fiddle. There's a brother and sister duo I saw back in Independence. They play guitar and banjo and sound amazing. We'd be lucky to have them. Last I heard, they were headed to Fort Bridger. Okay, I need to go to Fort Bridger. I think this is a real opportunity. What do you say? You know what? Yes. This is going to be a show to remember. Just you wait. I'll try to meet you again at Fort Boise. I know it's far away, but you'll need some time to get the band together, and I need to start writing some lyrics. These greenhorns heading across the Rockies know nothing about surviving in the mountains. It's awful cold up there, even in summer. Many a traveler crossing the mountains too late in the year has gotten snowbound and died. Yeah, we're pretty late. Be warned, stranger. Don't dig a water hole. Drink only river water. Salty as the Platte River is, it's better than cholera. We buried my husband last week. Could use some help with this harness if you could spare the time. I've never killed any of the Wasuku, and I have no desire to make enemies. All I ask from us is to be left alone and for the Tatanka to be left alone. Would that be the bison? Should I do it though? Because look, it takes a big chunk out of the middle. We're gonna need some medicine for sure. Oh. Okay. Tools. Restorative. This isn't a tool, but we sell it. Food. I need some damn wheel grease. Sometimes all I think about is you, late night in the middle of June. Think we have enough clothes. Can I sell things? Oh no, just discard. I want to leave room. Okay, I think... Wait, no. I'm gonna go back and buy some more clothes then. I'm half crazy. All right. Ba 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 baby. Independence Rock. Hoping to reach the rock before Independence Day, many immigrants carve their names into the rock face in celebration. See, that's just a jerk move. They're probably gonna make us do it. So our quest with Little Mary isn't done. So we're going to see her again. Founded as Fort William, renamed Fort John, then renamed once again, Fort Laramie was a major trading post in the Upper Platte River Valley. Perhaps it should have been spelled Laramie. However, for Jacques Laramie, the French-Canadian frontiersman, it had been intended to honor. So they misspelled his name. That sounds about right. A wave of anxiety mingled with excitement washes over the party as they leave Fort Laramie behind. A long journey lies ahead before the next chance to resupply. Oh, fiddlesticks. What happened? Where are we? Did we get lost? The wagon and his party find themselves led astray from the trail. We're 4 hours off course. There's some debate among the party about how best to return to the trail. Who should take the lead? It ought to be Boober and Goober, but let's see, Doober. Please be better than a three. Oh, shit. Doober picks up a glinting object from the dirt. Brushing the dirt aside, the object appears to be an old gold coin. A single eagle made of near pure gold, perhaps dropped by a passing traveler years ago. Such luck! After much delay, Doober guides the party back to the trail. Well, at least now we know Doober is not... Doober is not the one for that. Oh, wait, I forgot. I've got some books. Should have used that first. Okay. Boober, I believe you. Oh no, I don't want to use it again. We have 3 days. Happy lets out an ear-splitting cry and the wagon lurches suddenly. Tripping over a simple stone in the soil, Happy falls and finds himself crushed under the unstoppable wagon wheel. He has suffered grievous injuries and needs serious treatment. Oh no! The party should stop to treat him and allow him to rest and heal. Utilizing laudanum to relieve pain and aid healing would be best. It is standard issue in any pack of medicine, however, for an injury this severe, a lot would be required. Happy takes a large amount of laudanum. It takes a few hours to kick in, but eventually his pain eases and he's capable of walking again. It would be a good idea to seek further treatment when possible, however. That, and we need to drop our pace. Oh my god, we're going steady. Greetings, strangers. You must be my ride. I knew the captain would come through for me. What? Just drop me off at Independence Rock, if you'd please. Let's go. Oh. Excuse me, what are you doing? Without waiting for a reply, the strange, annoying man crams himself into the wagon as comfortably as he can. Seriously? Dude. Oh, I need to collect meat and pelts. I need to go hunting again. Two days of wagon grease expired. A minute. Is this? Are we serious here? I'm going to need to do some serious hunting and fishing soon. Happy sick, so Boober's gonna have to do it. So we need to get several pelts and 100 pounds of meat, plus that if we are desperately low on food. Because there's a man sitting in our wagon. I did not need to. Oh! I am bad at this. Well, we got our 100 pounds of food. And I think we get enough pelts to unlock the next part of that challenge. I think we need to collect 9 of these guys. Hopefully he doesn't want to ride in the wagon like Mr. Bigfoot here. Jerk. A woman draws near, dressed in the rough garb of a fur trapper. Folks heading west, you'll need meat then, and I sell it cheaper in the forts. Lord knows I can't carry it all back anyhow. Oh yeah, we talked to this lady before. Let's just see if we can raise boobers. No. Okay. Do we even have room, though, for that extra food? With Mr. Big Butt here? I guess we do have a little bit of room. You know what? Let's get 75 pounds. She can't carry it. We need it. Please, help me. Move along, strangers. This man owes us a healthy sum. $50 to be exact. There's nothing to be gained by getting involved in this. I beg to differ. Now, what are you planning? I'm planning on arguing. Who should argue? Now what? Let's send the priest. Shame. Shame on you. With a cool head and steady voice, Goober manages to convince the creditors to leave the man alone, at least for now. Oh, fine. We'll leave you alone for now, Ralph, but we'll be back shortly, and we'll be expecting interest. Ralph, dear. Thank you, thank you. Please take my medallion. It'll take a minute to compose myself and then fight the captain. I don't think I'm cut out for this kind of journey. No, it certainly does not seem it, does it? Wait, do we have room for fish? Oh yeah, we just discussed this. Happy broken leg day! Oh no! Goober! Oh, he's just a little sore. Thank goodness. Yes, that's it! Once a fish is in the trap, just pull it out and it's yours! Oh, hello, travelers! There's certainly a number of folks out here today. As you can see, I've already run into some. Mormons, they call themselves. Oh, honey. They've paid us to fish in our territories, but frankly, they're not too good at it. I've been trying to teach them, but to be honest, I'm not sure how they've survived away from their cities this long. You folks look like you're accustomed to handling yourselves and the environment already. Still, you're welcome to join in on the lesson if you like. Yeah, sure. Fishing is all about your attitude. The fish are smarter than you think. If you go in with the wrong thoughts, you'll have no success. The better your attitude, the easier the time you'll have catching fish. My people, the Agarica, use spears and nets, but when using your rods, you must consider similar things. You should aim to cast your line near where the fish roam. You may be able to spot them beneath the surface. Once the fish is interested, wait for it to fully commit to biting before pulling back. Different fish may be more or less shy about grabbing the bait. Make sure you learn the right feel. Once you've mastered these things, you shouldn't have much trouble. Of course, you could also use a trap. My people use them often. But that's perhaps not practical for traveling folk, such as yourselves. Maybe when we get a bigger wagon. Oh, yay! We actually did level up a little. I hope you gain something from listening, travelers. We don't want starved immigrants the length of your trail. The lesson concluded, the Mormons returned to stream once more. Let's approach the Mormons. They're knee-deep in the stream, desperately trying to eye any poor Piscine? Like Pisces? Shape that swims by. Oh, Piscine shape that swims by. They look up at the party approaches. We're all followers of a church. You may have heard of us. The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Bit of a mouthful, I know. Most folks call us Mormons. Our kind isn't much welcome out east anymore. We're heading west to a place called Salt Lake City. Our leader, Brigham Young, settled it a couple of years ago, back in 1847. Place for us Mormons. The journey there so far hasn't been so bad. We're part of a company, 50 of us all told. They're camping nearby, me and my husband here, and our friend. Friend? Thought we could come and try and catch some dinner. We didn't expect to find a Shoshone woman here, but she's been quite helpful. The Mormons are knee-deep in the street. Friend? If it's another woman, it's not a friend. It could be better. The fish seem to be wise to our tactics, and the Shoshone woman seems to take some small delight in our supper. Oh, she's been very helpful, though. Her people have a wealth of knowledge about these parts, and I'm glad she's taken the time to teach us. We might not have caught anything yet, but I'm confident it's only a matter of time. So what happens if we go swimming? Let's talk to Hidao. Mormons have been coming through here more and more often recently. They've set up a place they call Salt Lake City to the west. They always seem to be in a big group, lots of women and children, not the kind of people used to living outside of their cities. Nice enough folks, most of the time. This group seems to be determined to get along with my people, at least. Can't say that for all people from the east. If I help them a bit, teach them how we understand the Agai and how we hunt, maybe we can find a way to live together. There's more and more of them every day, though. At some point, there won't be room for fishing like this. Others in my village share the same fears. I hope you gained something from listening, travelers. You did. Oh, Goober, as it turns out, may be the best fisher. On the road again. I can't wait to get on the road again. Once I catch some fish, so we don't starve. It's a bony tail chip off. We did catch two. I thought last time the second fish got scared away. Oh my. I think that's quite enough fish. Something fishy this way comes. Woo! We got 64 pounds of fish. Stop! Is that it? What? What's going on? This'll do. I can walk the rest of the way. Thanks, friend. Have my medallion as a prize. I've got no idea what you could do with it, but I don't want it, so enjoy. He's so rude. Rude. Ooh. Oh. We got some dirty, stinky people. And he messed up my stores. Kind of feel like let's go ahead and do that. He's permanently. Ooh, makeba, 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 la, gotta, gotta, ooh, makeba, make my body dance for you. And our flowers infested with weevils. Good thing I just got all that fish. But yeah, what a waste of food. I guess the weevils didn't think it was a waste. Happy broken leg day! I think I misunderstood. When it said the wagon grease expired, I thought it meant like the can that I hadn't opened yet. Oh good, a campsite. We can rest. No? Oh, is this where we were? Yay! We finally arrive at Independence Rock. A foreboding, sprawling monolith stretching hundreds of feet into the air. The rock is smooth, barring, of course, the carved names and initials of previous travelers. Some among the party may take some satisfaction in doing similarly. I don't agree with it. Let's check the time here real quick. Yeah, we're at 30 minutes. Okay. Well, then I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.